Imagine yourself trapped in a large grassy area surrounded by a giant maze, and you're surrounded with people that you don't know. Now, what would you do in this situation?
This is exactly what happens in the movie Maze Runner. There are several areas in which leadership and conflict are portrayed. My name's Alyssa Suzuki.
My name is Tony.
My name is Cheyenne.
I'm Haley Coffey,
and I'm Haley Bush.
Okay, so in The Maze Runner, there are several examples of leadership and conflict. For leadership, there are several definitions that a person may have. At this time, we would like you to write down your definition on your worksheet. So, in our own words, leadership is defined as
working with others while taking other people's situations in their own hands,
taking responsibility and listening,
also having a vision and inspiring others to support that vision and creating their own. Some types of this would be a team captain, coaches, even parenting, and managers and CEOs.
and a curious individual who is willing to step up and take responsibility to their own actions. Also, able to take the best course of action for their companions, remain calm, and think of the most logical solution in the most hostile environment.
Gamble and Gamble define leadership as being the ability to influence others. Next, we'll discuss the traits that a person should have to become a great leader. To be a strong leader, one should have several different traits. On your worksheet, write down a few traits that you believe entail those of a leader. According to Kirkpatrick and Locke, a few traits include drive, which is a broad term that includes achievements, motivation, ambition, energy, tenacity, and initiative. It also includes leadership motivation, which is the desire to lead but not to seek power as an end itself. Honesty and integrity, self-confidence, which is associated with emotional stability, cognitive ability, and also knowledge of the business.
According to the Center for Association Leadership, there are eight different leadership styles. The first one is charismatic, and these people influence others based on their personality and are also passionate about their opinions. The second is initiative leaders. These people grasp the entire situation and go beyond what is usually done. They also find the problems and fix them. The third is command and control. These follow the rules and expect others to follow them too. The fourth is laissez-faire, and this is where they are not directly involved in what's going on, rather they're in the background. They trust what other people say, but still have their own words and opinion. The fifth is the pace setter, and they set the requirements for the team and evaluate the goals. The sixth is the servant, and they put others first. The servant also includes the team in which what needs to be done, and lets the team take credit for the results. The seventh is situational leaders, and they connect behaviors and readiness and are also direct and supportive. And the eighth and final type of leader is transformational leaders. These expect the team to transform to the needs. They are also the role model of the group, and they expect the best from others. Each person establishes their own leadership skills and styles depending on the situation. Some people may be a strong leader, while others not a leader at all. With leadership and leading others, conflict may also be involved.
Before we talk about conflict, take time and write your own definition on your worksheet. Next, we will define conflict in our own words. There are four different definitions that we came up with.
A disagreement or argument.
Disagreeing with ideas,
mental struggles,
and a difference of opinion.
Gamble and Gamble define it as a disagreement or war, battle, or collision. There are different types of conflict. There's external and internal. According to the Literary Devices, there are two different types. External is conflict between an outside source, and internal is a conflict between an inside source. There are three types of external conflict.
The first is man versus man. Now, this is conflict between two characters, both capable of human thoughts. It's an antagonist versus a protagonist, so it's the good guy versus the bad guy. Then it's man versus man, man versus nature. The protagonist is capable of human thought, but the antagonist is not capable of human thought. So this, for an example of this, would be a child being attacked by an animal. The third is man versus society. The protagonist conflict with society. And this is someone goes against society or a norm.
And there's one internal conflict.
This would be man versus self. Choices are involved, and it's self-conflict.
Conflict and leadership are well portrayed in the movie The Maze Runner.
And now we have the summary presentation. So, a 16-year-old boy named Thomas wakes up in an old service elevator and wakes up in a large grassy area called the Glade. There, he meets a group of boys who call themselves the Gladers, and they have formed a simple society with each person assuming a specialized task. Surrounding the Glade is large walls called the Maze.
Kendrick says that these boys are... As Tony mentioned, Thomas was one of the major people in the movie. There's also Albie. According to Dashner, Albie takes authority over much of what goes on in the Glade. He does not want to escape the Glade, and he has a command and control leadership style. This means that he wants to follow the rules and also wants others to follow them too. Another character is Newt. Newt is second in command, and he supports Thomas's plan to escape. Next, there's Teresa. She's the only girl, and she was sent with syringes that are unknown. Another character is Ben. In the movie, he was stung by a griever and attacks Thomas, which later leads him to be banished from the maze. There's also the runners. The runners are those who go into the maze and create a map to discover the way out. There's also the grievers, which are deadly creatures that roam the maze and attack those who enter the maze. And lastly, there's Ava Page. She's the administrator of Wicked and controls those who are in the Glade.
And here we have a trailer for you for The Maze Runner.
Who you are, where you came from. Can you tell me your name?
I can't remember anything. What is this place?
Welcome to the Glade. Who put us here? We don't know.
What's through there? You guys can't just take me here. I can't let you leave. Why won't you tell me what's out there?
It's the maze. Everyone in those doors are open. Look for a way out. No one has ever survived a night in the maze.
What happened, sir?
We call them grievers.
We don't belong here. Somebody built the maze. I think it's time we find out what we're really up against.
You're not like the others. You're curious.
What the hell is that?
This is the first real clue you found.
Dead. Are you sure about this?
No.
during the day, designated boys called runners would go out to the maze and look for an exit for a way out, and returning before dark when the entrance closes. The next day, Thomas is attacked by one of the gladiators named Ben, who has been stung by a reaver, which is one of the deadly creatures that roam the maze. The next day, the gladiators waited for a few runners to come back before the gate closed, but unfortunately, the two runners got really close to the wall, but was unable to make it back to the glade. Thomas ran out to the maze at the very last second, and the gate closed behind him in an effort to save the two runners. Thomas and another runner was able to kill a griever and retrieve a tracking device. With this, they may be able to find a way out of the maze. They make it back the next morning, and the boys are impressed, and so they made Thomas a designated runner. The gladiators meet the first girl ever in the glade named Teresa, and she carries two syringes with her filled with unknown substance. A runner that was stung earlier was able to use a substance from the syringe and recover fully and gain his memory back. That night, the gates did not close and the grievers came in and attacked the camp. Unfortunately, many gladiators died, and Thomas was stung. Thomas used the last syringe and regains his memory. Turns out, him and Teresa works for WICKED, which stands for World in Catastrophe Killzone Experiment Department. With the gate not closing, Thomas decides to lead the gladiators into the maze to try and find an exit. The group finds a tunnel and eventually enters a laboratory filled with dead scientists. The group reveals a video of Ava Page, who is the director of WICKED and of the maze experiment. She explains that the Earth has been destroyed by a massive solar flare, and a virus called the Flare affects many individuals of the afflicted, and gladiators are immune, and so the experiment was to study their brain. Our men rush into the laboratory and the gladiators are taken into safety. The Earth is scorched in the last scene, and Ava Page is supposedly alive with the dead scientists and declares the experiment a success. And so, in instances where Thomas showed leadership, is he became de facto leader after the grievers attacked. The survivors followed him into the maze to try and find exit. And in cases of conflict, the gladiators argued over whether Thomas really deserved being a runner because he lacked both experience and skill.
Throughout the movie, there were several instances of leadership. The main leaders were Thomas, Newt, and Albie. Thomas was a leader for several reasons. Leaders take time to develop, and when Thomas first entered the maze, he was definitely not a leader. When he exited the elevator during his entrance into the glade, he was very curious. He asked several questions. Although he was not a leader then, it later led him to make wiser decisions because he was informed about what was going on in the glades and in the maze. According to La Londe, he started out dazed and confused, but grew into a strong leader for the glades and managed to save many lives. When Thomas ran out into the maze to help save the two runners, this was where he showed innovative leadership. He takes responsibility for entering the maze, even though it wasn't safe. He knew he could help and wanted to do something to help the fellow runners and eventually escape the maze. In the end, he saved the runner, and he thought it was better than doing nothing. It was a game changer for the gladiators. He also was an innovative leader when he took initiative. He found the tracking device and helped to find the way out of the maze. When the grievers attacked the camp, he used situational leadership. He led the group out of the maze and helped others to survive and fight off the grievers. Another leader was Newt. Although Newt was not a strong leader, he did have some leadership traits. He was resilient in overcoming difficult situations. He picked himself up from past failures. He focused on the present and the future. He was motivated to continue going on, and he had self-confidence. He cared about what was going on and not what had happened in the past. He tried to do what was best for the rest of the group, and a quote that he said several times throughout the movie was, "Pick your ass up and finish what you started." Another leader was Albie. He was considered to be the leader of the Glade. He was not a very strong leader, though. He does not want to push ahead. In the movie, they discuss how Thomas wants to go out into the maze and to find the end so they can get out. But Albie was not one of those people. He wanted to stay in the past and stay in the Glade. He did not want to make any changes to what was going on because life was good as they knew it. He was a stagnant leader, had no situational leadership skills. He could not be a leader in any odd situations. Everything had to be the same for him. There was also several areas of conflict in the Maze Runner.
One type was man versus man. In the movie The Maze Runner, there's conflict between Thomas and Gally. When they first meet, they don't like each other, and Gally bullies Thomas. Neither of the characters get along at all.
We have a video showing this.
I try to push you out of the circle. Try to last more than 5 seconds. Ready? Come on, Greeny. Not done yet.
Stop calling me Greeny.
Stop calling you that? What do I want to be called? Shank? You know what? I think I'm still on Shank.
Another example would be man versus self. The people in the Glade and the mazes surrounding. One reason for this is that the people were scared of it and they worried about it. So they didn't want to leave or stay. Thomas faces tons of thoughts in his head about Glade and all the stuff that is happening. Thomas also doesn't remember anything that happened to him before he came to the Glades. Thomas also struggles when he has to figure out if someone is a bad person or a good person. Thomas struggles when people want him to make a choice.
Another type of conflict is man versus nature. This occurs when Thomas and Minho are faced with the Griever, which would be the nature monster. But this conflict is resolved when Thomas kills the Griever.
Another one is man versus society. This was conflict between the Glade and the creators of the maze. The creators stopped giving the Glade supplies and sunlight, which made the people of the Glade very angry, which created conflict between the Glade and the creators of the maze. Also, Dashney, the writer of The Maze Runner, puts Thomas in the situations of conflict to allow the viewers to react to how he reacts. Will he face his fears or run away from it? And he does this both so this vulnerability is seen. Because of this, the humanity is shown. This also allows the readers to relate to Thomas.
The Maze Runner has many concepts of leadership and conflict. Because of Thomas's leadership, he was able to get most of the people out alive and safe. Situational leadership. They were able to make it out of the maze and saved by armed men. They also found a way to resolve all the conflict between the people and the creators of the maze and Wicked, as well as the other gladers. Here's our bibliography.
Thank you.
Thank you.